Hello. In this video, I'll show you how you can calculate the heat loss from a room. In this room, there is a door and a window. The room size is 3.5 times 4.5 meters. That's the outside measurements. The inside measurement is 4 times 3 meters. The U value I use in this example is fictive. Of course, you use your own U value in your project. I'll start with the floor, and I assume without floor heating. The U value, I put in a fictive value, 0.12. The area of the floor, I can see on the drawing here, it's 4 times 3 meters. So that is 12 square meters. Then I need to find the temperature difference. And here I can go to the tab formulas. And here at the very bottom, here I can see the design temperature. And it's a floor. And I can see inside the house, I should have temperature of 20 degrees. And the soil temperature is 10 degrees. This means the temperature difference is equal to 20 minus 10, which is 10 Kelvin. And this is without floor heating. If I use floor heating, then it's a little bit different, because then the surface temperature of the floor should be counted as 30 degrees. You can see it here. And in that case, the temperature difference is 30 minus 10, the soil temperature, then it's 20 Kelvin. But today I'll use 10 Kelvin because it's without floor heating. So 10 Kelvin here. Then I can calculate the heat loss. We name it phi, the Greek letter phi, capital letter, and TR means transmission. So it's the transmission loss. And the formula for transmission loss is given here. It's the U value times the area of the structure times the temperature difference. And the final unit is watt. The unit for for U is watt per square meter per Kelvin, and the unit for area is square meter, and the unit for temperature difference is Kelvin. And then I can see Kelvin eliminate Kelvin and square millimeter eliminate square millimeter, so the final unit is that. So the formula, it's equal to the U value multiplied by the area multiplied by the temperature difference. So I have a heat loss of 14 watt through this floor structure. Then I also have a heat loss because of the internal walls, and I can try to indicate it here. Inside here. This also causes a heat loss. And I go to the tab formulas, and here I can see it. It's given here. And then you ask about the insulation in ground support slab. No insulation, less than 100 millimeter, more or equal to 100 millimeter. Today I'll use more than 100 millimeter of insulation. So I'll use this one. And remark, the unit is watt per square meter per Kelvin, so it's a U value. Then there are different ways I can make the internal foundation. I can make it in concrete with one light clinker block or two light clinker blocks. They suggest it here. Basically, if I have an internal wall like this, then I can make a light clinker block below it like this, somehow like this, and then I can place my ground support slab like this and the insulation here. Oh. Try again. And then I could place some, yeah, maybe one more block or only one, and then the in situ casted part. So this is the light clinker concrete. Yeah, this is not easy to see. I'll try to make this is in another color. So maybe make it in a gray tone. So this is the in situ casted part, the gray one. And then this is the light clinker block. Sometimes you have one and sometimes you have two of those light clinker blocks. So it's depending. And of course, often the floor is from both sides here. So like this. Today I'll use one light clinker block to be on the safe side for the U value. And then I can read here, if I choose one light clinker block and more than 100 millimeter of insulation, then it's 0.03. If I have two blocks, then it's only a third part, 0.01. But I choose one light clinker block today. So I put in here 0.03. The area, that's in this case the same as the floor area, so I simply just drag and drop this value. The temperature difference is again 10 Kelvin, so the heat loss is 4 bat from internal foundations. Then I have my external wall here, and before I calculate this, I'll take the rebates, the window and the door. The rebate, you can see here in the tab formulas, is shown like this. In this example today, I have a site rebate here. I could name this site rebate. It looked like this. And I know the width of a brick is 108 millimeter, and I also know that the U value through the ordinary external wall is lower than through the rebate. That's why I need to take that in consideration. Then I also have a top rebate which look like this, and here I know the height of this is the same as the height of a brick. It's 45 millimeter. Yeah, and then I assume today that I don't have a rebate down here. Sometimes you have a rebate here at the window sill, but today I just use this, so I don't assume additional heat loss here. So only the side and the top rebate in this example. So I need to find the area of the top and side rebates. I could start to find the side rebate. Try to make it with the blue color here. Each side of the door and the side of the window. So then I could make the calculation down here, rebates, and then I could choose the blue one here. The width is 108 millimeter, so and the length of the side rebate is equal to, I first take the door, it's 2 times 2.15 plus. Then I have the window, it's 2 times 1.20, So now I have the length of the site rebate, then I multiplied by the width. It was 0.108. So this is the area of the site rebates. And then I take the top rebate. I could colorize that a red one. This one here. And the top of the window. Like this. And in this case, I assume I supported 108 millimeter to each side. So all over 108 millimeter here. And also here at the window. So I'll calculate the length down here. Oh, it should be red. That's one. Then I can calculate the area of the top rebates equal to, I first take the length in the door opening, so it's 1 plus 2 times 0.108. That was the length at the door opening. Then I take the length at the windows opening. It's plus 2 meter plus 2 times 0.108, parenthesis end. So now I have the length at the top rebate for the door and the window. Then I multiplied by the height here, and that is 0.054. That was the height of a brick. Yes, so now I take the sum. So this is in square meter. And if I round up, then it's 0.91 square meter. I assume in this example a U value of 0.35. It's a fictive value. You calculate it on your own hand. The temperature difference, I need to look in formulas and here down at the design temperatures. I still have indoor 20 degrees, but outdoor it is given as minus 12. So this means the temperature difference is 20 minus minus 12, which is 32 Kelvin. So, and again, the formula for phi is U multiplied by the area multiplied by the temperature difference. So 10 watt through the rebates. Then I'll take the window. The U value for a window, you can look up on the producer's websites. I'll just take a fictive one here, 1.1. The area of the window, that should be quite easy, it's 1.20 multiplied by 2 meter. And the temperature difference is 32 Kelvin as before, 20 inside and minus 12 outside. So I have 84 watt through the window. Then I take the door and again, you can look up on the producer's website. The U value depend on a lot of factors. It depends on the materials it's made of, and also if you have glass in the door. Also for the window, the U value can vary. It's depending on how many layers of glass, and also the frame glass ratio. But I'll put in a fictive value here, 1.2. The area of the door is equal to 1 meter wide times 2.15 meter high. The temperature difference is again 32 Kelvin, 83 watt in heat loss. Then I can take the ordinary external wall, because this is the same as taking the total area minus the rebates, minus the window, minus the door. Then I have the net area. So I can write here, it's the net area. So I put in first the U value here, I assume 0.2, it's a fictive value here. The area, equal to. I know I had 3.5 meter here and 4.5 meter here. And when I calculate this, I always take the outside measurement and to the center of the internal walls. So the length of this is 3.5 plus 4.5. That's the length of the external wall. Then I multiply it by the height, is 2.4 meter. Now I have the entire area. Then I subtract the rebates, the window, and the door. So 13.75 square meter. The temperature difference is 32 Kelvin, 20 inside minus 12 outside. So 88 bed. Additionally, I have some heat loss through the different joints. I have joints around the door here. I have joints around the window as well. And also here at the foundation and at the bottom of the door. So let's try to start here. First, I take the joints at the heavy external wall and window slash door. We name it phi SA. Let me see here, window heavy external wall and window. Yeah, this is maybe not right here. Yeah, it's right. Okay. We name it phi SA, and it's the Greek letter, the small Greek letter phi SA. It's the joint between the heavy external wall and window slash door. And I'll try to colorize it here. I can maybe use a green one. No, an orange. So it's this joint between the door and the external wall. The bottom at the door, I'll not take in consideration here, because that is this one, phi fx. And then I take around the window here as well. So like this. So it's the orange one. The length, no, yeah, the length I can put in here first. It's equal to, take the door first, it's 2 times 2.15 plus the top, that is 1 meter. Then I take the window, the perimeter of the window, yeah, strongly I don't need a parenthesis here, equal to 2 times 2.15 plus 1, that was the door, plus, then I take the perimeter of the window, that's 2 times 1.20 plus 2 times 2. So I have 11.7 meter at the window and the door. That's the length. Then I need to find the linear loss, and I go here in formulas, and then I go up here. Here. I have chosen here sketch 1. From DS418. There is a lot of sketches here, so there are different ways how you can connect the frame to the external walls. So take care and find the proper sketch. I think there are somehow more than 10 of those different solutions. I have chosen sketch number 1, where I assume the frame has an overlay of minimum 20 millimeter related to this insulation here. But look carefully at the sketches in DS418. I use here today sketch 1 here. And then down here in this table 6121A, here I can see, can I make this a little bit smaller? Here I can see the cold bridge interruption here. I assume today I use 30 millimeter. Of course, that can also be different how much insulation you have here, but it's just an example here. Then you asked about the material of the outer leaf and the inner leaf, and today I assume brick and brick. So I have here brick and here brick. In that case, 0.03. The temperature difference is 32 Kelvin because it's placed in the external wall. So 11 watt. And remark again here, the linear loss, I can see the unit for linear loss is watt per meter per Kelvin. It's stated here. And the length is meter and the temperature difference is Kelvin. And then I can see Kelvin eliminate Kelvin and meter eliminate meter. So the final unit is watt. Then I have the joint at the heavy external wall and the foundation. And I could try to colorize this green. This is this one. And this one. And this one. So this is the green line. The length of this, it's quite easy because that's 3.5 meter plus 4.5 minus the door opening. So 3.5 plus 4.5 minus 1. So it's 7 meter. Now I need to find the linear loss. So I go here and see. I have here chosen from DS 418. I choose from figure 6.13.1. Here I choose solution A. There are different ways you can solve this connection or this joint, but I have chosen this one with this cold bridge interruption around the ground supported slab. This is this one. If I choose this, then I can go down in this table here, 6.13.2b, and then I'm asked first if I have insulation above the concrete, and today I assume I don't have anything. Then I'm asked how do I make the foundation, and I assume today I use light clinker concrete, the upper 14 centimeter central insulated, and then there is a note M1, and M1 is 150 millimeter of insulation. So I assume in this example today that I have two of those sandwich blocks. Somehow like this. And one more here. So this is what I assume in this example here, and then I have my ground supported slab here with this edge insulation here. And then polystyrene, etc., and the capillary breaking layer. And down here, of course, have my in situ casted part. And maybe I have my terrain somewhere here. So this is the one I have chosen today. So, and then I'm asked about the U value for the terrain deck. And then if I go back, then I have chosen here 0.12. So here I can choose between three different values, 0.3, 0.2, and 0.1. So I choose the one closest to my own value. So I should pick up 0.13 for phi F. 0.13. The temperature difference is again 32 Kelvin, 29 watt through this green line. Then I have the bottom at the door. The length is 1 meter. This is this one here. It's 1 meter, so that's quite easy. Then I just need to look up for phi fx, and I have here linear loss at foundation and window door, and there is a lot of possibilities. The one which is closest to my solution is sketch 5. It looks similar to this solution up here. So I'll choose sketch 5, and then I can read in this table 613 6A. This is phi fx. The u value for the terrain slab is 0.1, this is the closest one. And then again, I need to read carefully. Upper core central insulated with 100 millimeter. It seems the one, both cores central insulated, seems to be this one. Upper core, both cores central. Need to read carefully here because there is a note set MD, MND. I'll choose this one. Both cores are central insulated with 100 millimeter. Then I can find it here, 0. And it's okay. I could make it speedier. It's related to sketch 5, so it was just speedier just to look up here directly on the sketch number, and then I could find it speedy, 0.21. The temperature difference is 32 Kelvin. Now I take the sum of those transmission losses, it's equal to sum, parentheses start, and then I mark up. So, oh, wait a little, I try again, sum, to have all, just to be 100% sure. Yeah, then I have a heat loss of 330 watt. Additionally, I need to ventilate the room, and this also causes a heat loss. There are two methods, you can do it, naturally. If you choose this method, then you need to have some valves in the wall, or at the top of the window. I'll put in here for natural ventilation here the heated area, and that's important. The heated area is the outside measurement of the room because I need to heat up both the inside area and the external wall. So it's equal to 3.5 times 4.5. So it gives me additionally heat loss of 183 watt because of ventilation. The formula for natural ventilation you can see up here. It's given here. It's a constant 1.21 multiplied by 0.3 liter per second per square meter. This is from the building regulation. And then you need to multiply it by the area and the temperature difference. I already have included this in the formula here, so the only input you need to make is in this blue cell here. You can see the formula here, it's 1.21 times this from demand, the airflow, times the heated area, times the temperature difference, so it's already implemented. Finally, I can find the total heat loss if I choose natural ventilation. That's the transmission loss plus the heat loss from the natural ventilation. So 513 watt. If I choose mechanical ventilation, which most modern buildings have, then there is a little complicated formula here. You can see it here for mechanical ventilation. It's given here, And I already have prepared this formula here, so you can just make the input directly here in this blue cell here. The heated area is again 15.75. Then if I choose the mechanical ventilation, then the heat loss is 88 watt from this system. So it's less than the half than if I choose natural. Finally, I can take the total heat loss with mechanical ventilation. That's the sum of transmission loss and the heat loss from the mechanical ventilation. So in this case here, 419 watt as heat loss. Yes, this was how you calculate the heat loss from a room with a window and a door.